Welcome to Your Voice, a program for you to see how your voice is being represented in the New York State Senate with Senator John Bonacic. Thanks for joining us. I'm Julia Locandy.
Julia, good afternoon. Nice to see you today.
Me
haven't
too.
Seen you in a while.
I know, it has been a while. There have been a lot of events in Albany. You've had some local people up and getting awarded, and you know, it's wrapping up. Session's wrapping up.
Yeah, I find that like the last 2 weeks in Albany of session days, it's really about 15 days, we get jammed with so much legislation, and the lobbyists come in, the advocates come in, and they all advocate to get a bill passed. In addition, there's a lot of ceremonial events coming up. So we're extremely busy at this time of the year, and we wind up probably the third week in June, we'll be out of here.
Right. As the chairman of the Judiciary Committee, the CASA program is something that you advocate for, especially during budget time. We always hear about that. You had a bill relating to this that just passed the Senate. Tell us about it.
Well, what I had was a request in the budget to get CASA more money. Now, CASA, for people that don't know, it's a volunteer program. These advocates have been trained, and what they do is they try to resolve children's issues, whether foster parents' issues with children, neglected children, and they advise the family court about the situation and their suggested recommendations, therefore putting a less burden on all of our state agencies that watch out for children. And they do it very reasonably. You know, we got them about $800,000 and they literally save millions. So I was trying to get this bill in statute. So when the budget time comes, if it's in statute, the chance of recurring funding is much greater. Mm-hmm. So that was the purpose. And I think I spoke on the floor on it, I think.
You did. Let's watch you make the case for this.
Okay. There were 79 volunteer fire companies that responded to a forest fire of 2,000 acres in Ulster County. And they were all volunteers that took time from their family and jobs to do that. And the tremendous debt that we owe to volunteers. And you would say, why did you start off this discussion about a fire and volunteers? Because this bill is about CASA. CASA is also a bunch of volunteers throughout the state that are trained to look after children's welfare, foster children, children that have been abused, and they make these reports to the family court. So the family court is more knowledgeable on how to handle cases before them. And they do a tremendous service. They handle thousands and thousands of children. And each year, my good colleagues in the Senate passed this bill unanimously. You did it in 2014, you did it in 2015, and I hope you do it today. We get no movement in the Assembly. And why do you think that is? Because if you went in your district and asked anybody about the CASA program, they would tell you it's exemplary, and thank God for these volunteers. It's because it's a food fight for the dollar. You see these organizations, legal aid, welfare organizations, they're always a category in the budget, and they always get money. So they do not want to see CASA elevated to a statutory reimbursement in the budget. And by the way, it's $800,000. And they save the state millions because of less burdens on all those state agencies that are supposed to look after children.
Okay. $800,000 seems like a drop in the bucket you think about that.
It is for statewide.
Yeah.
But they do tremendous work, and I believe in the program, and I've seen its success. And it's, as I said, it's a limited dollar. And the forces that are getting money always want to keep those, without the funding.
Mm-hmm. Well, Thinking about volunteers and people making our community safer, the Woman of Distinction ceremony was last week.
Awesome ceremony. We have it every year. Flo Santini was my Woman of Distinction. And we pick a woman who is not successful in her job, but who gives of herself to the community helping others. That's the mission and how we pick a woman of distinction. So I was pleased that when I called her, Flo, and I told her she was my woman of distinction, she cried on the phone.
Aww.
She was so touched. And when she came to the event and we put her on TV, she was fighting tears. She just recently lost her husband a few months ago, and she said, I wish he could be here to see this. I said, he is here. He's watching you. You know, but it was a wonderful, wonderful ceremony.
Let's take a look.
Sure.
We have a party going on behind us. It's all the women of distinction of the state of New York. And I have my woman of distinction, Flo Santini, from the town of Deer Park. A wonderful woman that does so many things for the community.
Florence Santini was elected Town of Deer Park tax collector and then was handpicked by the retiring town clerk to succeed her.
Today, we're honoring you as a rock star, but we always appreciate everything you do every day. You're not just a town clerk. You've been involved in so many things. Tell us some of the things you've been involved in.
Well, one of the things I enjoy, we started our program with our seniors. We do a Thanksgiving Day dinner, which grown from 38 to over 200 that we give a free dinner for in November. I do St. Joseph's Place. I volunteered there. I belong to the VFW, the Ladies Auxiliary.
Ms. Santini was instrumental in obtaining a beam from the 9/11 tragedy, which impacted her family personally. She created a beautiful memorial in front of Town Hall and organizes a 9/11 service every year.
And I thought we were going to get a small piece of iron, and what we got was an 11 and a half foot beam. And we raised over $10,000 in a month to take this beam and secure it. And we had two monuments, and it sits on a monument. And every year, our ceremony gets bigger and bigger. And no matter what day it's on, we have more firemen from that stay home and come to our service than go down to the city. We have Blackstone, we have the Twin Towers, we have a monument with three angels that are flying up to remember the three sites that were hit. It's just awesome.
I've participated in the 9/11 ceremony in the town of Deer Park, and it's one of the most beautiful 9/11 monuments that has been created. And people stop there not only on 9/11 ceremony, all the time to remember those that have lost their lives and keep our heroes safe.
Senator, I can't thank you enough for what you've done. It's just very special. I touched my heart.
It's not for what I've done.
No,
it's for what you've done.
You nominated me, and this here tonight, I've never seen anything like this. It's very special.
You know, everything she does comes from the heart. We love those people.
Mm-hmm. There's another person that you are very proud of, and you introduced him during West Point Day. Let's take a look.
Okay.
I would like to introduce my cadet, Angelo Matz. Angelo, please stand up. Angelo was a plebe. He tells me first year is always tougher, but it'll get easier, Angelo. Angelo also has grandparents. Arthur Gray, Senator Arthur Gray, was his grandfather who served in this chamber. So to Angelo and all of the cadets that are here today, I want to thank you for giving us hope, inspiration, but mainly you protect our families, you protect our community, you protect our way of life. And we pray that the Lord will always keep you out of harm's way. God bless all of you. God bless this great country.
Yeah. What a great Senate tradition.
Oh, and you know, I always tip my hat to Senator Larkin,
yeah,
because you know, they had a little get together
with the Lieutenant General and in Senator Larkin's office, and he got a civilian award. And I said, he's not a civilian. He's still a military man here, because that's all he does, is how proud he is about the military. And he wears all of his emotions on his arm about the military. Mm-hmm. And thank God for Bill Larkin, for his love of the military, which we all have. But he expresses it every day.
Now, if we can, get in one more. 4-H, they came in to visit you.
Yeah, 4-H is not a gambling club. It is a club of young students that usually their parents were involved with farms, and they know, they're learning about the farming business. And they always visit with me, and they came from four counties, and they went on the Senate floor, and we greeted them.
Mm-hmm. All right, let's watch that too.
I had plenty of young farmers in training visiting with me from Orange County, Sullivan County, Delaware County, and Ulster County. And, you know, we're all striving to keep the agricultural industry strong and alive in spite of what our governor's been doing. And I asked them, do you have an interest in going into farming? Because what we're hearing is many of the younger generation wants to do something else because it's so difficult, farming. So I asked them, are you interested in staying in farming? And I was surprised. The majority of them said yes. And in the 4-H, they learn about the care of animals. They learn responsibility. They learn a work ethic. They learn for respect of the land. And as a result, this resolution is statewide for all 4-H youth that are in our districts throughout the state. I'm here to welcome them and thank them very much for all that they do within the 4-H community.
I'm so pleased that these young men and women want to stay in farming, because statistically, the farming industry, most of them are over 75. So every six farmers over 75, we only have one young farmer coming into the business. So it's critical that we keep young farmers interested. And we have a host of benefits that try to encourage young people to come into farming. And the Senate has been very active with that, with scholarships, with seed money to get them started, with land purchases. So we continue to try to keep our agricultural industry strong.
Thank you so much, Senator, for coming in and talking to us about all these great New Yorkers.
Yes, thank you, Julie. Always a pleasure.
And thank you for watching Your Voice with Senator John Bonacic. For additional information on what we discussed today, bonacic.nysenate.gov.